Okay, so now we will start. In last lecture, we had course introduction. We had gone through the curriculum, examination scheme, and your evaluation scheme. We had also seen introduction of physiological modeling. What is modeling and why there is a need of modeling? Also, what are the different perspective of the modeling that we had seen? So it's time to see what is mathematical modeling. Mathematical modeling is nothing but see, difference between mathematical modeling and modeling is modeling can be of different type. One of the type is like, for example, physical modeling. You will physically replicate the system. You will physically replicate a human body system, just like a brain. We can see that to study anatomy of the brain. We had seen the physical models of all the organs, like our teachers or our professors have used that organs. So that are physical models. But many times, this is the requirement of system physiology or the modeling. It's like you cannot use the physical modeling every time. Or the requirement says that you need to represent the model in terms of the mathematical equations for further analysis, for representation, or for further interaction. For example, I want to control something. So to apply my design control strategy, I need the inputs or I need that model parameters in terms of the mathematical equations. I want that. This is the need for representation of the model in terms of the mathematics. So in this course, we'll see some network related problems also, but in that case also we'll represent that network issue for the network model in terms of mathematical equations. So in this course, whatever models we are going to study, ultimately we will represent that model in terms of one equation or a set of equations. So that is why we call it as a mathematical model. This type of a models can be classified in different ways. One of the classification says that the model is you can divide the whole range of the models into linear and non-linear kind of the modeling, where the equations which represents your model are linear and non-linear. Another classification can be a deterministic or probabilistic. In deterministic type of a modeling, your parameters or the output or the parameters are determined that can be determined that are fixed. But in probabilistic type of a modeling, they are probabilistic. You cannot say fix. You cannot fix determine those parameters. Again, you can divide the whole model range, the complete models. I mean, the whole range in statics and dynamics kind of models. Also, you can divide these models into discrete and continuous. So these are few classifications. You will say that my model is nonlinear probabilistic or nonlinear static kind of a model, or you can say that my model is a discrete linear model. So these are the types or the features which the features defines its qualities and properties of the model. So this is what is the classification which is used in case of the modeling. So basically, how to model, how to go for the mathematical modeling. So two fixed approaches are used. Okay. But whatever the approaches we are going to use, they are not limited to these two, but these are the gross two approaches which are used. One approach is a black box approach, where in a black box approach, it's like you don't know what are the internal or the middle parameters or we are stay in control system point of view. I mean, in control system, you said that the state variables. So you don't know that intermediate parameters. you have a set of inputs and you have set of outputs, and for that set of input and output you train your model. So that is what is called as a black box approach. Another approach is a building block approach, where again the building block approach is divided into two types, that is a microscopic approach and a macroscopic. Microscopic means you are looking into minute details. This is also, I mean, at a very small level, small details, you are deriving the model step by step, and that to be considering all variabilities and all parameters at the microscopic level. So this is also, you can call it as a distributed model. And at macroscopic, like you are considering, you are using an approach of the functions or say blocks, or again, another words used for this is a lump, especially lump. So it's like instead of picking up a small things, you are just picking a block. Like for example, you want to write a C program. So to write a C program, there can be two approaches. One, you can use the readily available functions and make use of that functions to get your task done. And another approach can be you can write your own instructions to get the task done. So while writing your own instructions, you may write a function where inside that you may write your instructions. So that is what is an example of a microscopic modeling, where you are writing each and every, or you are designing each and every module at micro level. Whereas if a set of function is readily available, you are just picking that functions and I mean sequentially you are just executing that functions to complete your task. Then in that case, that type of a modeling is called as a microscopic modeling, or that approach is called as a lump approach, or specially lump approach. So microscopic modeling leads to partial differential equations, whereas the macroscopic or a global modeling leads to a set of ordinary differential equations. For example, the microscopic approach can be used to derive the velocity profile for blood flow in an artery. But the global or microscopic approach is needed to study the overall behavior of the circulatory system, where not a single artery plays a role, but it's a set of arteries, a complete network of the arteries. So to study the overall behavior of the circulatory system, in that case, macroscopic approach is used, and where you want to study only velocity profile for blood flow in a single artery, then in that case, that microscopic or what we call it as a distributed approach can be used. Distributed approach is used. So these are the different approaches which are used for mathematical modeling. Here, the points to remember are two important approaches. One is a black box approach, where you don't know what is inside that black box. You know only set of inputs and set of outputs, and you're training that black box for that set of input and output, so that if an input is given within the scope of that input given, it should give you the respective output. Another approach is a building block approach, where you will study each and every part of the physiological system and you will build your model. So now this building block approach has two subtypes. One is a microscopic approach and another is a macroscopic. In a microscopic approach, you consider the minute details. You model for minute details. And in macroscopic approach, you don't consider the minute details, where you consider the whole system, or you consider it as a lump, as a function, say as a block, as like a, for example, difference between modeling of artery and modeling of the circulatory system. Just now in this case, for modeling of artery, microscopic method is used, and modeling for circulatory system, the whole, where there are n number of arteries which are involved, arteries as well as vein. So it is impractical to model for each and every artery. Instead of that, the set of the arteries is considered as a circulatory system, and it is considered as a lump or a block, and then it is model for blood flow. So that is called as a macroscopic approach. These are the approaches which are used for mathematical modeling. At this point, you just try to understand what are the approaches. When we will actually model, your understanding will be more clear at that point. Before going to the modeling steps, I just want to confirm, are you guys are in line with me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So these are the steps which are used for the modeling. Before modeling, what is available with us is a real world data. From that data, we have to extract the information. What is the information that is available? And based on that information, you will formulate the model. You will represent the model. Okay, that formulation can be of any type. It can be electrical, it can be mechanical, and any other types. And then you will design or you will formulate your model. After formulation of the model, you will go for the analysis. You will analyze that model. Analysis means you have designed your model. Now it's time to represent that model in terms of, say, mathematical equation, or simulate that model and test it, conclude it, calculate few parameters from that model. For example, a simple example I'll take. It's like, say we have a road network of the roads, and say I want to travel from college to Pune station, COEP to Pune station. This is what is my aim is. So now your aim is to design an app or a system or design a model just like a Google map, which will redirect me that use now at this time, use this route to go from college to Pune station. Okay. So now your aim will be, it should be shortest route. Another aim will be, you should reach within less time. So for that, you will look for the traffic, where on which route there is a traffic, or where it's a jam and signals, etc. So these are your objectives, right? So for these objectives, you have a network, you have a network of roads. So you have represent that network of roads in terms of the nodes. Say each square, I am representing each square in terms of one node, and then I'm drawing connecting branches in between the nodes as roads, and distance will be assigned as weights. Okay. And if it's traffic, I want to apply a rule of the traffic, then I'll just assign one multiplication coefficient to that. That is called, I will call it as weight two, second weight, right? So now in this case, I have a model ready with me, a network model. Each square is represented by nodes, and the roads are nothing but a connecting link between the nodes. So what I'll do is I'll just find out by which way. I know this is my start point and this is my end point. I know what is my destination. So I'll just search all the possible routes. Right. So which routes gives me a minimum distance? And then again, I look for the weights, secondary weight, where for that I'll calculate the time. So which route gives me less time? Right. So this is the model. The model, you have designed the model and your model is ready. You have used different approaches, like you found out the shortest route by say, we will study these things, because in biomedical also you have similar kind of an application. So we'll use different algorithms. So different algorithms are used here, like Dikshitra's algorithms and etc. to find out the shortest route. So I mean to say that you have designed this model, but how will you analyze? You need to do analysis whether your design is perfect or not. So that is what is the requirement of analysis. Your algorithm has told you that this is the shortest route and this is the route which gives you or which will make you reach within less time. But how will you make sure that this is the exact route? You need to check the accuracy. So that's why this analysis is important. And from this analysis, you must come to some conclusion. And from that conclusion, there should be interpretation or whatever the output that you have got, whether it is the actual shortest distance or whether it is giving you the route, actual route for shortest time. So it should be explained. You should do it explanation. You should interpret what is the output is, whether it is correct or not, whether it is precise or accurate or whatever. And then you should be able to explain it. You should be able to test it with the real world data. After this, you should be able to test it with the real world data. And after testing, if there are any flaws, say my model is not perfect. It's not perfect for all the routes. It's perfect for a particular route. It's perfect for within a particular distance. But it is not perfectly working for all the routes. Then in that case, you should be able to reformulate. You should be able to relook into your design. Or you need to relook into your design. You need to modify the design model and then retest it. So this will continue, this loop will continue unless and until your objectives are achieved. Yesterday we talked about that these objectives or the specifications for the modeling. So before starting your modeling, your objective should be clear, and based on the objective, once our objectives are clear, we are free to assume something like if we want to go for that. Okay, so it is easier for us also, for design also. So once you achieved your objective, you can stop these iterations or you can stop this closed loop. And then you can say that now my model is perfect as per these objectives. And these are the assumptions for this model. Then you can define, then you can see, and then you can use that model for another purpose. For example, the same example, map. Once your model is ready, once it is trained and it gives you required objectives, required accuracy, and it is tested for a required number of samples required accuracy, then you can say that, okay, now this algorithm is fine and it can work to find out the shortest route, and that to be you will be able to reach within the less time. So now we can go for the development of the app for this design model. So this is the way, or this is the methodology which is followed for modeling. So these are the steps which are used for modeling. Is there any doubt? Are you guys in line with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So now,
yes, ma'am.
Can you imagine and can you rethink examples of this type? I mean, examples of modeling, and put your examples in the steps. Any examples? I'm not expecting examples from physiological modeling, like modeling of a physiological system. You can take example, any example, just like I have taken example of maps. Can you take any example and describe your model in the steps, how you will design? Anyone? anyone can say. Okay, do you need some time to discuss?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, I'm guessing like designing a cloth or
okay.
Means for designing we have to collect first raw materials
Yeah.
To formulate it then to test it on trials or
Okay. Yes, correct. Go ahead.
Yes, for that first we like we sketch what type of the model it would be
Okay.
then it would be analyzed by giving different contrast, different colors, how it what is the combination, what must be pattern.
Okay.
And then we interpret on or we go on trial.
Okay.
If there is mismatching or something that is not happening, so we can continue it like we do as
okay,
a modeling.
For example, there is a loose fitting, so you can
Yeah,
again correct your formulation and make correct it so
yes,
that
yes.
for perfect fitting, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, good example. Thank you, Shivani.
Thank you, ma'am.
Anyone else? Huh?
Can I give a software example?
Yes.
Ma'am, if we are going to develop a website, then first we have to collect data or a market survey on it and
Okay.
collect some raw material or content from the client side. Then we have to decide the designing part and then we have to flow chart of the website and then we are actually developing the website and after developing the website we are going to check the quality of the website
Yes, correct. Go ahead.
Quality of the website from the quality control department and then we launch the website in a real world.
Okay, you check the quality and if there are any flaws, then you correct it. Reformulate your flow chart and architecture and then you make the necessary changes and then you will finally launch to the customer, right?
Yes,
so this is the similar kind of a scenario.
Hello ma'am.
Yes Reena.
Yes, ma'am, I want to do another example.
Yes.
So ma'am, actually I am considering this electronics part example. Suppose I want to convert some binary data into mathematical or mathematical data into binary. So first of all, I will raw materials, that is what is the problem facing, that is according to survey, like if I want to design some electric circuits, so I will consider this problem first of all, then design the model according to what I want the output. Then after that designing model, I will go to mathematical conclusion, that is if I design this model, then I get correct output or not. Then after that, if I getting correct output, then it's fine by testing. Otherwise, I have to again do the correction in that. So according to this, we can also design a system like this.
Okay, so you will measure electrical parameters,
Yes,
whatever the
yes.
parameters are coming. If they are not correct, you will modify the circuit and again.
Yes.
Okay.
In programming, that is whenever we are testing something, this device, that time we are considering the part of electronic part only, controlling part, that microcontroller, microprocessor. Then I can change
yes.
the program and find out errors and get proper output.
Correct.
Is it okay, ma'am?
Ah, yes, correct.
Okay, thank you.
Okay, thank you, Rina. So, who else is remaining?
Hello, ma'am.
Yes, yes.
Sudarshan here. I want to give an example on Ford factory, which made the chips or something like that. We make the model that give the correct weight of the chips packets, and we make the programming and the mathematical calculation, and given the accurate weight of that particular packets, and we mathematical calculation, and we make the correct model of that weight. For example, in grams, we make the model.
Measurement
is important that for, and we make the model correct, and hello.
Yes. Yes. Hello. Continue.
And we collect mathematical after the mathematical conclusion, interpretation, and after the test of we give the real data data, and
you will check its accuracy, whether it is measuring the correct weight or not. If it is not measuring, then you will again remodify your measurement system.
Yes.
Is it?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it the weight, Sudarshan? This is what you want to say?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Hello, ma'am.
Yes.
Can I give another one example?
Yes, Reena.
Oh, ma'am. Actually, I was doing the project on ultrasonic and flex sensor. So this is one also correct means good example, I think, because first of all we are consider the problems what we have the output finally. So on ultrasonic sensor and flex sensor, both are different, but if I consider ultrasonic sensor, then up to what range I require to beep the buzzer. So first of all I will design the problem. And according to that, I will make the programs on Arduino or another one, microcontroller, microprocessor. Then after that, testing this program, and if you are getting proper output or not, according to that, we can change the program and getting output.
Yes, correct. Now see, now you must have understood that you are modeling at each and every step. Or you already have the skill of modeling. We are utilizing this knowledge or the skill of modeling at each and every step. This is what we are doing, right? So this only thing is that in this course, we will learn few new techniques, how you can find out analogy with the electrical circuits and how you can find out the analogy of the physiological system with the mechanical one. And how to represent our physiological system in terms of a in terms of the model, and how to write mathematical equations for that. So basically, the concept says that you are representing, and these are the steps which are used for the representation. So now we will move ahead.
Can you give an example on biomedical instrumentation? Biomedical instrumentation, मतलब कुटे हो तो can I give example?
Okay, you want an example of a biomedical modeling?
Yes.
So, in physiological modeling, One example I want to give here is say, I have lots of examples. I mean, you will study all kinds of examples here. So one example is evaluation of a drug model. Okay. So I'm talking about drug model at a microscopic level. This will best fit this kind of a process. For example, a new drug has been designed and we want to check its response. What is its response? What happens when it is injected inside the human body? So before testing it, actually testing on the human body, it is first tested on animals. Okay, it is first tested on in the labs with different experimentation, and then it is tested on the animals. See, animal under test considered here is a mice. So it is tested on say a sample of 1,000 or a sample of 100 or 150 mice. Consider that it is tested on a sample of a 150 mice. So after testing on a 150 mice, testing means a fixed amount of an drug is injected inside the mice body, and then say after a 30 minutes, if my lab reports are saying me that its saturation time is 30 minutes. So after 30 minutes, if I'm we are just checking what is the drug concentration after 30 minutes inside the mice body. So after 30 minutes, we'll just check what is the drug concentration level. Now, in this case, we already have mathematics, compartmental modeling. We already know the mathematics of the drug response. So we will try to put the actual values, that is a peak response after 30 minutes. Duration, time duration we'll put as a 30 minutes and we'll give that values. These are the peak values of the drug dosing inside this mice whose weight is this and like this, whatever the parameters are. And we'll try to fit or we'll try to design that drug response model for a particular drug. In short, we know the model, we know the mathematics, and we are trying to calculate the parameter values for that model. So again, what we will do is once all the parameters value are fitted, we will do it simulation, and again we'll check whether mathematically also for a particular weight after this time we are getting this peak value or not. If we are not getting, again we will remodulate it or reformulate it, and again we will check what is the actual response is. So this is the way population kind of if modeling is done for a population. One example I have given in terms of the mice, but similar kind of a methodology is used for humans also. Once it is tested for its side effects, then it is modeled for its drug response, for accurate drug response. So this is the example. This is a microscopic kind of a modeling. So shall we move ahead?
Actually, ma'am, we can design a surgical also.
Surgical what? Surgical what? Instruments.
Yes, ma'am. Surgical instruments. Me.
म्हणजे मला कळलं नाही तुला सर्जिकल इन्स्ट्रुमेंट कसे डिझाईन
करायचे. ऍक्च्युअली मॅम वेन मतलब सर्जिकल सर्जरी होती ना आपली, तेव्हा मग आपण यूज करू शकतो का? हॅलो.
हा हा, मग कसं यूज करणार, काय करणार?
नाही जेव्हा आपली एक फॉर एक्झाम्पल सर्जरी राहते, मतलब डोळ्याची या अशी कुठली तरी म्हणजे गुडघ्याची वगैरे, त्यावेळी आपण ते सर्जिकल हे वापरतात ना इन्स्ट्रुमेंट, ते आपण मॉडेलिंग थ्रू वापरू शकतो का?
मीन्स यू विल
प्रोग्रामिंग करून
हाँ यू विल एक्चुअली वॉन्ट अ प्रिसाइज कट ऑफ दिस मच ओनली राइट.
हाँ यस यस मैम
यस यस इट इज यूज एंड दिस मेथोडोलॉजी इज इन एक्जिस्टेंस. हेल्थ केअर टेक्नॉलॉजी मध्ये ऍडव्हान्स हेल्थ केअर टेक्नॉलॉजी मध्ये ही टेक्नॉलॉजी ऑलरेडी यूज होते. ऑपरेशन होतात रिमोटली, ऑपरेशन होतात, रोबोटिक सर्जरी. यू माइट बी नोइंग द वर्ड रोबोटिक सर्जरी. सो दिस इज द कंसेप्ट विच इज यूज देयर. मॉडलिंग प्लेज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रोल देयर. Okay, shall we move ahead? So now, while these approaches are there for continuous time modeling, set of differential equations will be derived, and for lump time modeling, difference equations will be derived. So here also one example, like nerve firing in the central nervous system can be modeled by using discrete time event theories. Or random walk models and queuing theory models are some examples of discrete time models. So the again, this is one classification, like deterministic and stochastic models. So deterministic modeling examples like describe the rate of change of volume of an arterial compartment to be equal to the rate of flow in minus the rate of flow out. It's nothing but it's similar to like you have a tank and water is coming in into that tank with some rate and water is going out from the tank with some rate. So if I will ask you what is the volume of the water inside that tank, so if initial volume is zero and you know what is inlet flow and you know what is outlet flow, so after a certain time you can say that this is the volume inside the tank. So similar kind of this type of an example. So this is called as a deterministic modeling, and where stochastic modeling regards the probability of increase in the volume of the compartment in an interval to be dependent on the probability of transition of a volume. Like instead of a determining, I don't know the all parameters. So in that case, all things becomes a probability. Like probabilistics, then in that case that model becomes stochastic, because some of the parameter is not exact or it can be determined. So in that case it becomes stochastic. So how modeling can be done in that case is we are calculating the mean, or we call it as average, and then from that we are calculating variance, that is a standard deviation, and then covariance. And based on these parameters, we are designing the model. So these are the two approaches. So the real world is complex, it is non-linear, non-homogeneous, and it is often discontinuous and anisotropic. It is also multi-layered and multi-dimensional. So the system of interest is isolated from the rest of the world by using a boundary, because practically it is not possible to incorporate all the variabilities. So the system is then conceptually reduced to that of a mathematical model by using a set of simplifying assumptions. You need to be fixed, you need to decide your boundaries. And you need to assume something, or you need to keep a set of assumptions, and then and only then the model results have significant limitations, and are that's why your models have limitations, and they are valid only in the regime where the assumptions are valid. So it is practically impossible to design a universal model which will work for all drug responses and which will give you a response of all drugs with all patient variabilities and etc. and etc. So that's why whatever model you will design, that will have limitations, and it will work only within that boundaries, only for that particular region. So this is the conclusion or summary of the model. Are you guys in line with me?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is a simplest way to represent a mathematical model. Like your dependent variables are function, or they are represented in terms of the function, and the function of independent variables and parameters and the forcing functions. So this is the simplest way to represent a mathematical model. I think we have already discussed this point, right? Why physiological modeling? Only thing is that there are two types of the physiological model. One is a quantitative model and another is a qualitative model. In quantitative one, the mathematical representation approximates the behavior of an actual physiological system. And in qualitative one, it describes the physiological system without the use of the mathematics. Like two approaches, where when in quantitative we can quantify the behavior, and in qualitative it is just describe the physiological system without use of the mathematics. That is a qualitative model. So these are a few examples of the physiological models, like drug model. We have already discussed this drug model. Another example is a virtual human body model. Virtual human body model. There are so many examples for virtual human body model. One of the example I can give you is, say, for electrostatic discharge. You might be knowing that in winter season, if you will touch a metal part or say metal door, you will get a shock or a small kind of a spark. So what is that? In fact, a charge is developed on the human body. An electrostatic charge is developed on the human body. And that, excuse me. And that electrostatic charge gets a path to the ground via that metal. So that's why you get a kind of a small jerk or shock. This electrostatic discharge is very hazardous for electronic circuits. And what if you will practically, if you'll actually calculate the charge which is developed on the human body, it's sometimes it is in kilovolts. So for testing the electronic circuitry, whatever the electronic circuitry you are designing, whatever instruments you are designing using electronics, that instrument should be free of this electrostatic discharge. Or there should not be any effect of the electrostatic discharge on the instrument, right? So in this case, how you will replicate the human body so that, like whatever the electrostatic discharge that comes on the human body, you want to model that discharge and you want to design the electronic circuitry for that. So that whatever instruments you are going to design, you will test that instrument for the electrostatic discharge. So this is one of the example of virtual human body model. Like you are modeling the human body for electrostatic discharge. Anatomical model, example of the anatomical model, I can say that I want to check my walking cycle, how it is, whether there is any fault, say if my knees, if I'm getting some extra pressure on knees, or if my walking cycle is not perfect. In biomedical terms, we call it as a gait cycle. So to check or to test the gait analysis, you can go for the anatomical model. Circuit models, there are so many examples of the circuit model. Arterial network model, just like a map, just like a road model, this arterial network can be modeled. Biomedical signal models, or biomedical signals can be modeled for, say, stimulators, as a stimulators to test devices and devices that are designed or instruments that are designed. So there are n number of biomedical signal models. for each signalized type, each abnormality can be modeled by this way. So these are few examples of the physiological models. And this is one example for you to solve. Can you solve it? Can you see my screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. I'll just give you 5 minutes. You please try to solve this example. Or what you can do is you can note down this example and solve it. Consider this as an homework and we'll discuss in next lecture.